The Chosen One's Journey by Dragonwolf12. A couple of days later, Ash, Brock, and Misty were making their way through a dense forest, trying to make their way to Fuchsia City. "It shouldn't be too far from here," Brock was saying. "Where is it?" Misty asked. "Over the mountain," he said. Ash blinked and looked around. "Which mountain? We're surrounded by them." Brock pulled out his map and examined it. "Maybe this way, maybe that way, or that way," he was muttering to himself. Ash sighed. "We're lost, again."
"Well, it keeps things interesting," Wartortle commented.
"That's a matter of perspective," Gyarados said.
"Hang on, there's a road here," Brock said.
"Then let's go," Misty said.
They started walking again, when suddenly an explosion shook the mountain.
"Whoa, what was that?" Misty asked nervously.
"It came from over there," Ash said, already running towards the source.
After running for a few minutes, they came across a large road covered with construction trucks. Up the road, they could see a massive dam being built. Another explosion shook the valley, and they could see massive rocks being blown away from the mountainside. Suddenly, one of the trucks near the front of the pack tipped on its side, causing a massive pile-up of all the trucks.
"What a wreck!"
Misty exclaimed in shock.
"This is terrible," Brock agreed.
"Come on," Ash said. "Let's go see if they need any help."
The three of them went running down the hill towards the head of the pileup.
"Ash," Pikachu said as they ran, "I can hear Diglett below us."
"Are you saying they caused the wreck?" Ash asked.
"It's too early to tell, but most likely," Pikachu said.
As they neared the first truck, a man came stumbling out.
"I just can't take it anymore,"
he cried, pounding his fist on the ground.
"Are you all right?"
Ash asked as he ran up to the man.
"It's the Diglett!"
he yelled.
"They're destroying everything!"
"Are you sure it's the Diglett?" Ash asked.
"See, they're right over there!"
he said, pointing to the road. Sure enough, there were several Diglett moving around.
"Oh, look how cute they are!"
Misty gushed.
"You think they're cute, do you?"
the man shouted in a fury.
"Thanks to them, we can't finish building that dam! I hate Diglett, I hate them!"
he said, ripping apart his hard hat. "That is a problem," Brock said in thought.
"They even created a special division for developing strategies to fight off the Diglett," the worker said. "They're calling for any able Pokemon trainer who's traveling through the area. Someone with real Pokemon know-how who can help us get rid of these Diglett. The reward is a 6-day, 7-night stay at the famous Sivka Hot Springs Resort. If you know any Pokemon trainers..."
He was interrupted by the screeching of tires. Ash's jaw dropped when he saw who was standing in the car. Gary Oak.
"The first Pokemon trainers have arrived," he said dramatically. "The rest are in these buses."
He gestured to four large buses right behind his car. Ash rolled his eyes.
"You never change, do you, Gary?" he asked.
"Huh? Who are... Well, if it isn't little Ash from Pallet. What are you doing here?"
Gary asked.
Ash scowled.
"You're from Pallet too," he said.
"Well, it may just be an unlucky coincidence," Gary said. "Only the best were invited."
"Then how come you're here?" Ash asked.
"Me? Because I'm Gary from the town of Pallet, the number one trainer."
He looked up to the sky as if the light of heaven were raining down upon him. He then pointed at Ash.
"Ash is fourth."
Ash raised his eyebrow.
"And what makes you say that?" he asked.
"You are the fourth to leave home," he said.
"Fourth?" Ash demanded. "I got to the lab before you even woke up. Just ask the professor."
Gary snorted.
"Fine, but as a trainer, you're dead last. Now watch as I step up to the plate and hit a Pokemon Grand Slam."
Around him, his fan club started throwing confetti. Ash just stared at him incredulously.
"He's very..."
Misty began.
"Detestable," Brock finished. "So, Ash, have you picked up any good Pokemon?"
Gary asked cockily.
"You have no idea," Ash replied, grinning.
"Can we please get to the business at hand?"
the construction worker screamed.
"Somebody's got to get rid of these Diglett! Don't forget, a resort vacation!"
"Don't give it another thought, sir," Gary said. "Those Diglett are as good as gone now that Gary Oak is on the case."
"Do you always have to refer to yourself in the third person?" Ash asked, annoyed.
Gary just got into his car and drove off, shouting,
"So long, losers!"
Ash let out a sigh and pinched the bridge of his nose to try and get rid of his Gary headache.
He's even worse than Squirtle was, Gyarados commented.
Hey!
Wartortle said indignantly.
Sorry about that, Ash said to his friends. Gary is Professor Oak's grandson, and it went right to his head. It doesn't help that he actually is really knowledgeable about different Pokemon because of Oak's private tutoring, so he can usually back up his boasting.
That sounds pretty annoying, Misty said.
What happened, Ash?
Brock asked. You usually have a sharper tongue when dealing with annoying people like that.
Gary is so full of himself that insults just go right over his head, Ash explained. There's no point even bothering.
I see what you mean, Misty said.
The three friends were standing in the middle of a large crowd of Pokemon trainers. All were looking at the head construction worker as he spoke to them through a megaphone.
We greatly appreciate all of you talented trainers interrupting your training to come here and help us get rid of the Diglett.
He pulled down a large sign that had a picture of a Diglett on it with an X through it.
Pokemon trainers, here you see Diglett, the greatest parasitic bug Pokemon of the century.
Just a minute, Gary interrupted, raising his hand. Technically, Diglett is not a bug Pokemon. As a matter of fact, the term mole Pokemon would be more appropriate. With a height of 8 inches and a weight of 2 pounds, they're hardly candidates to be the greatest anything of this century.
Diglett are also ground-type Pokemon, Ash added. Any attempts to attack them as if they were bug-types would end in failure. Also, Diglett and their evolution Dugtrio are among the fastest-known Pokemon in the world. They may seem weak, but together they can destroy. The construction man suddenly gasped and started shouting,
It's the Diglett! It's the Diglett!
Everyone turned to see several Diglett had appeared, and they were attacking the buses that the trainers had arrived in. Gary ran out and said,
I'll take care of this.
He pulled out a Pokeball while his fan club started chanting something about Diglett.
Now everyone will be able to see the top Pokemon trainer in action.
He kissed the Pokeball and threw it.
This should do the trick.
The ball landed out on the field and burst open. But before the Pokemon could fully form, it returned itself.
Hey, what?
Gary said in shock. Ash narrowed his eyes. Something's not right here. Gibble, will you go talk to the Diglett and find out why they're attacking?
Sure,
the Landshark Pokemon said. A Diglett suddenly appeared under Gary's Pokeball and brought it back to the Pallet Trainer.
Oh, thanks, he said, taking it.
Then suddenly, he realized what was happening.
Wait, this can't happen?
Ash grabbed Gibble's Pokeball and tossed it. He landed on the ground digging and was instantly underground. Gary was staring in surprise at the hole.
Huh? What on earth was that Pokemon?
He asked in shock.
Well, Gary, Ash said mockingly, who'd have thought that there would be a day when the great Gary Oak didn't recognize a Pokemon?
Gary glared at him.
Fine, I'll just bring out my best Pokemon. You can't handle it.
He kissed the new Pokeball 3 times and threw it.
Go get him!
Again, the Pokemon refused to come out of the Pokeball.
What's going on here?
Gary asked, and he rounded on Ash.
How come your Pokemon comes out, but mine refuses?
Ash shrugged. It's not that the Pokemon refused to come out, it's that they refused to battle. I just wanted my Gibble to talk to the Diglett, so he came out. And here he is now. Ash looked down to see his shiny Gibble emerging from the ground at his feet. Gary looked down at the Pokemon in shock. He'd never seen anything like that before. He pulled out his Pokedex to scan it, while it jabbered to Ash.
Unknown Pokemon. No data available.
Ash smirked internally as he noticed Gary trying to scan Gibble. Once Gibble was done explaining, Ash looked up at the construction worker.
When you finish that dam, what's going to happen to this valley? He asked.
The man blinked at the question.
It's going to fill up with water. A new lake will form.
Ash pulled another Pokeball from his belt and released Lucario. How many wild Pokemon can you sense living within this valley? He asked. Lucario closed his eyes, and the appendages on his head started levitating as he scanned the valley. Gary looked like he was going to have a heart attack. He tried scanning this new Pokemon, but again there was no data. Just how many rare Pokemon had Ash captured? He'd also noticed the sparkle when the first Pokemon was released. It was shiny.
Hundreds, if not thousands, Lucario reported.
There are hundreds, possibly thousands of Pokemon living in this valley, Ash announced.
He started to use his aura to project his voice to every human in the valley.
many of which will lose their homes, even die if this dam is completed. The Diglett are just protecting their homes and way of life. Just over that rise is a massive garden that the Diglett and Doug Trio have spent their entire lives creating. Building this dam is not only illegal, according to league laws, but also immoral. As Ash finished his speech, every person in the valley was staring at him wide-eyed. Then, as one, they all rushed towards where he'd been pointing, all wanting to see if the garden was real. Ash followed along at the end, himself eager to see the beautiful garden that Gibble had told him about. When they reached the top of the rise, everyone let out a gasp. There were hundreds of Diglett and Doug Trio, plowing the ground, planting trees, and digging water trenches. Wandering all around were water and grass-type Pokémon, watering the plants and helping them grow stronger with their spores. Taking in his fill, Ash knelt down and started petting Gibble. "Wonderful job, Gibble. Thank you for your help," he said. The head construction worker was staring in awe. He seemed to understand exactly the kind of destruction finishing his dam would do. He lowered his head sadly. "This project is canceled. I won't build the dam. I doubt the Diglett would let me anyway." Ash smiled, his mission accomplished. He sensed a pair of eyes watching him, and he turned to see Gary staring at him with a calculated look in his eyes. "You know, I think I was wrong about you, Ash," he said, surprising the Guardian. "You're a better trainer than I thought, but you still can't beat me." Ash smirked, same old Gary. "We'll see about that. I'll see you at the Pokémon League. We can have our epic battle of legends there." "That's a deal," Gary said, holding out his hand. Ash shook it, sealing the pact. With that, Gary went back to looking at the garden. Ash smiled at his rival and childhood friend. It would be nice to have the old Gary back, but he knew it would be a long road.